Hello, my name is Christian Walter, and today I would like to present you some information regarding indicators or strategies for TradeStation, how to use them efficient, and how to create alerts and for which tools you can use them. So there are many things what you need to know. Also how to create your own indicator or strategies or combine two existing indicators. This will be all the topic for our video today. And now I want to switch to the video itself.
Welcome back to our indicator and strategy webinar. We can see here the TradeStation 9.5 global platform with a matrix radar screen and a chart. And the topic today was or is indicators and strategies. First of all, I would like to start this in a chart analysis window, what's I think the most common thing where you will need the indicators or strategies. So if you have a stock future or a chart of an indice or whatever you want to analyze of an indicator, you just right click to the chart itself, and then you have here insert analysis technique, what is also called indicator, or insert strategy. And I would like to start with the insert analyze technique overview, because we have several indicators already included, which you can see now in the screen. I hope you are also able to double check this on your own platform. And for the beginning, I would like to choose a very simple indicator. What is RSI? So before you insert this to your chart analysis window, you also have the possibility to check a definition. All indicators have an explanation on the TradeStation Help website, where it's exactly explained what this indicator relative strength index calculates, what are inputs which you can change, how it should look like. So I think this is for all standard indicators which are already included in the platform very helpful. So as soon as you have something what you might not know, let's say strategy equity, you can click here on definition, and you will get an exact explanation how this indicator works, and maybe you will also find some new indicators which you didn't see before, and you can easily open them here. This is the first thing. Second thing, we want to go into the programming itself. Can also double check the easy language. So let's do this for RSI. All indicators, all strategies what are included here are open source. Not open source, but you can see the programming behind. Just click on edit easy language and you can exactly see how it's programmed. And you can use this in the next step, what I said in the beginning. If you want to combine two things, let's say I want to combine an RSI together with a moving error bridge, then I can use this to create a new indicator, which I will also show you later to give you some idea how to do this yourself. So these are the first two things. As soon as you go to insert analyze technique, you can click on definition and edit easy language. And when you want to include it, just click to OK, and you will see exactly here how the RSI was moving the last days when this Netflix stock was oversold or overbought. And you can also change like colors and stuff for this. I think not so important, but the easiest way to do so is to right click on the indicator. You can, if you select the indicator, just right click and say format RSI, but the other way is also possible, just right click and format analysis techniques, because then you will see if you also have some other indicators already included, how you can change them here. So just select the one you want to change, go to format, and under inputs, you can also change color here. You can change, we can say, for example, we want to have the oversold below 20 and overbought above 80. And we don't want to calculate these on 14 candles. We want to calculate this, let's say, on 21. And just press OK. And then we will see, OK, there was no time when we higher or lower this oversold order overbought values, where it was in this region above 80 or below 20. This is the easiest thing what everyone can do without having any knowledge about programming. The second very important thing, what I will show you also later in the radar screen, is from my point of view, the alert function. It's the same way, maybe I did it a little bit fast. If you go back again to format analysis techniques and then to format of the indicator where you want to change something. You have a lot of information here, inputs we already discussed, and for me, very important here, this tab for alerts. You can enable alert here. Can also say how many times the alert will come up, if it's just once or per every bar. And then we will later set on here what type of alert we want to set up. There are three different types of alerts, which I will also show you now in the next minutes. So the first thing, we will enable the alert. Normally I do it once per bar, depends of course for the interval which you are using. Then for the alert notification, I always use the custom settings. And then you can decide what you want to have, audio, visual, even you can do it via email. I will just have a sound. You can choose even different sounds. You can also say play once or play continuously. If there's a text, for example, we can, in every indicator, we can say ASI is above 80, then there will be even voice to text, voice text to speech. So your computer will tell you ASI for Netflix is above 80. It's also very nice. So if you're not in front of the computer, you will exactly know from where this alert came. But with the pop-up window itself, it will also help you to find the right workspace or the right information from where this alert came. Especially if you need or use more than one indicator, this will be very helpful to know from which workspace or from which indicator an alert was generated. The other easy way is just to use different audio tones that you know, okay, this is coming from ASI indicator, another sound or another song. You can even upload your own songs if you want to have this. It's coming from moving average. So this is all, or you're able to set this up as you would like to have it. There are many different ways to change the settings here. So this is yeah, the important thing to set up an alert for the chart. I will just leave it like it is, and maybe yeah, we're still a little bit far away. We can maybe try another symbol to see if we can generate an alert, but later on I want to include it the same indicator. Let's check, maybe the same indicator for radar screen, and there should be easier to get an information about it. So for the radar screen, it's I think more convenient if you have 10, 20 or 30 symbols included. You just go the same way what we did in the chart. You go right click in the radar screen, and then there's format all analysis techniques. It's not insert because there are already some columns included, and every column is considered as an indicator here. So we will do exactly the same here. We will check for ASI at the indicator, and then this indicator, not for the indices because I don't have the real-time data. It's also always very important that All the information here on TradeStation only works with real-time data. As soon as you see in D and bracket means you're on delayed data, and then indicators might also not show you the correct value or no value at all. So and here it's exactly the same thing what we need to do. I just want to check if we maybe get a symbol on a different scale. Not for the values which we have here. We can try it one more time on 1 minute chart. Oh yeah, that's good. So you can see everything what is above 70 is red, and now we will also see the alerts itself. Just make it a little bit faster because it's the same. You go again to Fumada indicator, RSI, then enable alert. And now I just want to have it as a pop-up window. You can even set up the time for the pop-up window. If you're not in front of the computer, you can leave it always open. But again, this also depends on the time or on the amount of indicators and alerts you have set up here in your radar screen. So I will leave it for 30 seconds because if it's too much, it can also make the performance a little bit slower of your trade station or of your computer. So just make sure that there are not 50 alerts per minute. But I think this is also something what you will see while with try and error. So you need to test this yourself to make sure it works in the way you want to have the alert. And to show you the alert, I need to, you see, for example, would come the next alert in the next minute. Just let me close. And then you should see the alert in this pop-up like I showed you earlier on the screen. If you have more workspaces than one, for example, I have only the TSIB default workspace here. I will just open a second one. So here we go. You see the alert indicator existing overboard zone. I click on the indicator and the indicator will jump directly to the workspace where this alert was generated. And yeah, now I don't know if you hear the tone. This was the tone which I set up the background. Normally I use this if I'm not in front of the computer, if I'm doing something else on the computer, I normally just need a pop-up window. So because the pop-up will come up in front of your application. So even if you're in a Word document, in Excel or in Outlook, you will see this pop-up, click on the pop-up and it jumps directly in the workspace where this alert was generated. And this is the easiest way to make your trading more efficient because you will or you need to set up these alerts in the way what you would like to see, what is an interesting entry for buy or short seller position. And then you can double check all the information in the chart what you need to have before you open a position. I think this makes things more efficient in your trading strategy, especially if you're not trading only in one specific symbol or one maybe asset class is not so important. But if you just trade, for example, Euro USD, then you just need to implement it in a chart analysis window. But if you have more than five, six different symbols which you would like to trade or where you want to invest, then it will be more comfortable to do this here in Radar Screen. And for all indicators which you included, I can just make a second one. Let's say ADX. You can also go to Format, Sort, and then you will normally be able, you can normally here select different indicators to sort them. If I want to see everyone or everything what is oversold, I can just go here RSI, say every 30 seconds he should do this new. I mean, in a 1 minute chart, it makes only sense every 60 seconds, I think, but then you can exactly see all the forex pairs or currency pairs or equities which are overbought at the moment. What is Netflix, Euro USD, Australian dollar, US dollar, they always come on top. And if you do this in a binary way, let's say with one or zero, you can also add more than one sort function here, what's quite convenient. If you go to format and sort, you can select the second one. Makes only sense if the first one is in the same value. So that's what I say. This is easy things what we can include in this indicators. We can say everything what is overbought is having number two, oversold number one, and then you can add a second sort function or third sort function, which really helps you to find the right ways here on the radar screen. A question from the live chat, if this is also possible for the web browser. This is only available in the TradeStation platform, not in the TWS. It's really only here in TradeStation 9.5. Of course, if you are a TradeStation securities client in the US, it's in the same way possible. But outside of this, there's no possibility to use workspaces like this. But if you see any workspace, what you want to use, I should switch off the alert because now it's coming quite often in your TradeStation platform, then feel free to contact us. We can also provide this workspaces. I mean, they're just a little bit changed from what you normally see when you download the first time the TradeStation 9.5 platform. So this was the first thing for indicators. Second is strategies. Strategies are only available for the chart itself. It's exactly the same way what we did with the indicators. You just have to press insert the strategies, and then you have a pre-selection. It's just all standard strategies, depending, of course, on the same what indicators will calculate. The difference is indicator will show you exactly in the chart the value. The strategy will just buy and sell when certain conditions are reached. For example, if we stay on the example for the relative strength index called RSI, there's a long and short entry, and I think you know how it will work, because if it's above 70, the RSI indicator will sell short, and if it's below 20, or in this case, depending how you set up the inputs, it will buy this symbol. And this is exactly what this indicator will show here. We just now need to double check which values are used in the indicators. And then it's similar to what we did with the indicators. You just have to go to format strategies. And then you see here the same format, and you can choose here the oversold, the length, because we calculated on 20. It's always important also if you see like different values in radar screen and in chart, in the chart window, make sure you have the same interval. Should be all, if it's 1 minute, set up to the same. And also make sure that you use the same inputs calculated on the length or oversold and overbought. So what I will do, I will set it a little bit lower. And the same for the short entry, we will make it a little bit higher in this case. And yeah, we see in this case, there is only one entry, a short entry here. It's exactly matching what we had here. This should be like almost, let's check if we have the same input. Oh, we have 20 here. Yeah, there was exactly 1 minute here yesterday in the Euro USD, where we had it above 80. And then just the last thing, we will enter stop loss and Another thing should be profit target. Where you normally also should be able to select different inputs, different values. What is your stop loss? What is your profit target? Here in this case, none of them get already reached. But we can also change this here. If I go to format strategy one more time, this was a short entry, so we need in this case amount. Yeah, okay, for Forex amount it should be much lower. And the same for the profit target. Yeah, then we can exactly see two times the stop loss was working. Okay, we can play around with this information, and then later on you can even get a strategy performance report here for the results of your strategy. You can even optimize them from the inputs to find out the right or the correct inputs for short or long entry. So this should be very helpful if you want to use strategies. Very important fact, just for you to know that for TradeStation Global at the moment, you can implement strategies, you can backtest them, you can optimize them, you can even automate them, but for the moment only, it's very important, only in the paper trading account. We are still using here some tests at the moment to set it up for the live trading account. For the demo or paper trading account, it's possible at the moment. Just generate strategy here. You have to check this box, then also automate execution. You see your paper trading account number behind, and then with account confirmation on or off. Off means it will be all automatically without any confirmation from your side. If you're a TradeStation Securities client, this is working. I don't know how many years already, but this is possible to automate it also in the live account. We really hope that the same will be available for TradeStation Global till the end of the year. And I can only recommend, if you really want to go deeper into generating maybe your own indicators or own strategies, that you get used to the programming language itself. There are also commands which make it a little bit more easy. How to build this strategies or indicators always the same. You have to find your inputs, then a few variables you need or what you use. There are some plots, especially for indicators, where you see the results, and then your criteria for alert or for color should be also included if you want to set this up. And then you can also copy this easy language code and implement it in your own strategy, just using maybe some different commands. You should not use the same and change it here in the original indicator. So if you want to really combine something with ASI, I will just do the following. I will create a new indicator. Test 1, 2, 3. Then I copy it here, and I can now add some other criteria from the moving average, from some volume information, depending on what you want to put together. But this is also pretty simple without having a really deep knowledge about the language. And as I already said, you can also contact us. We are happy to help you with the indicators and the strategies.
I hope this was an interesting topic, what we presented today for the indicators and strategies. If you would like to see more videos, please subscribe to our channel to not miss any of the upcoming videos. And for any questions related to easy language, to indicators or strategies, feel free to contact us. We are happy to help, and also visit our webinars page to see what are the next upcoming live webinars. Thank you very much.